characters. I don't think Marth is one of them, though, and Rangunshu is very well-versed in a lot of matchups.
I mean, it depends if Steakhouse is willing to camp and to what extent.
Right.
I remember Steakhouse playing him. Red X, a Link player from NorCal, beat him, and then...
Oh my god.
That was smart.
Yeah, Rangunshu, I think he's currently second in Ontario.
Oh!
The dude has traditionally been a Lucario main.
That's his thing. That's right, I remember.
The thing is, like, I'm in a NetPlay server with a guy, and we play all the time. Mm. The thing with him is he refuses to play Lucario on NetPlay because he does not like the frame lag and that it affects his play on CRTs because Lucario is such a timing tech-heavy character. So we started picking up at the Fire Emblem characters. He has a Marth, a Roy, and an Ike, and all of them are very good. In fact, his Marth has been pretty solidly beating JJK very recently.
Wow.
From what I know, their last set, it was a 3-0 in Rangunshu's favor.
Wow, good for him.
His Marth is really good.
Yeah, you can see. I might have to play him later. I better start watching this, because I can't play Zelda Marth anymore. I have to play Sheik instead. But the thing is that, like, Steakhouse isn't doing much in terms of camping. So
he's forcing the issue too much. You can't do that against Rangunshu because he's gonna. If there's anything the dude's good at, it's figuring out habits and adapting them. He adapts very quickly.
Mm.
So if he notices that Steakhouse is just gonna kind of run at him, then he's gonna do everything in his power to make it look like it's safe for Steakhouse to run at him, so he can punish it.
Look at a bomb, though. He can definitely live this. Yeah, or he can just get dared.
Yeah, you know. Yeah, in this matchup, Marth has the superiority in terms of combos as well as just spacing with regular tilts and smashes.
Yeah, but Tink should be winning neutral and kill percent,
because he's got three projectiles. He's just really not using them. He's like running at him with short hop nairs, and that's not working out for him.
I mean, it works as a mix-up, but you can't do it all the time.
Yeah, it's not a mix-up if you do it like five times in a minute.
Yeah, like if you're on one platform and Marth is above, okay, that's a smart trade.
That's a start.
nice
cancel.
Yeah, I respect that.
Showing himself that he's still in the game.
So yeah, he's rolling in. Okay. I don't know how much Marth experience Steakhouse has, so we'll see. He's being particularly aggro in this game. He was very willing to pull bombs against my Zelda last year, so.
That's probably perception. A lot of people like find Zelda to be a matchup you have to camp in, and Marth not so much. It's just kind of advisable.
Oh no, Rasengu knows. I'm saying you can do the pivot F smashes.
Yeah, his pivots are insane.
Oh no. I gotta talk to
Douglas.
He's just
such a mechanically sound player in a lot of ways.
Yeah. This is really impressive.
Oh!
Until that happened.
Okay, that was sick.
This is 100% doable until that happened.
Bye bye. He was making a good comeback there.
Okay, Steakhouse can definitely take a game, possibly to set as well.
If he just plays back a little bit more and doesn't force the issue against Rangunshu, I feel like he's going to have a much better chance of taking games.
Nice bands.
I don't know about this.
It still works. I still think Toon Link wins on this stage, or at least wins neutral. But
right, because he has all these platforms to just chase people with projectiles.
Mm-hmm. That's an interesting down smash.
The thing is, it's also easy for Rangunshu to chase him with the platforms, as well as just kind of shark him with stuff.
Yeah, that's true.
Plus, if he gets hit by a straight F smash or even like something weak like it, fair in the wrong place, he's just going to die for it.
The upside?
I feel like Tink wants space so we can just kind of space out Marth with projectiles.
And he knows how to deal, and Rasengu knows how to deal with the platforms and knows the F smash spacing, so.
Right. Up tilt?
That could have been a down air.
I thought it was a down air coming too.
Oh,
that was greedy.
Very.
That was a greedy side B.
That was very overextending. He's too confident, dude. You won. You got JV. You won. You JV2'd. Like, this is not the time to style.
I mean, that's just kind of what he does. If you can, you will, right?
Ooh, that was really close. If Marth went for ledge, that would have been over.
Yeah, not quite. Good DI. Didn't get the tipper. Thought I heard an air dodge sound.
Might have, I can't tell. It might have been Marth or something.
Maybe. Now Toon Link is like noticeably different though.
Yeah, that's true. That was actually not.
Wow, how did he not punish that? Rangunshu's reaction speeds are normally that he should be able to punish that.
I mean, it's something. I mean, you know when you get something that's like you cannot, you never expected someone to do in the first place, and it's like you have to take like a good half second to be like, oh, they just did that.
That's fair.
That happens with people.
Oh,
and now,
not quite. Yeah, that was a questionable up B.
That was, but...
Is it there?
Yeah, he just starts spamming down air, and it's... Like, you're up. Mart's up air can beat it, but it's hard to space
right.
it.
Right. More often than not, it's going to end up trading, which is the last thing he wants.
Yeah.
That's what it's just going to pop Toon Link up a little bit more, and it could possibly kill you.
That would have grabbed, unfortunately. Why isn't he going for the grab, I wonder?
I don't know. He had the opportunity. There he goes for it.
Yeah, okay. Oh, okay. Barely missed.
I like the setup of falling up air into down smash. That was smart. Just a little bit off the mark.
Yeah, like, this is a lot more even than the last game, that's for sure.
Okay, that's not quite going to do it. Toon Link's still a semi-fast follower. He's not going to... That...
Yeah,
no?
Just rack up damage this way. Yeah, it's...
Oh! Bomb into...
Yeah,
that was good.
He's very... Martha's very consistently dying at around... yeah, that kind of almost didn't kill. If that was like 140, he could have lived
right.
that.
That was good DI. Dragon Gunji just caught him because he got the boomerang and thought he was going to be able to go in. He got
no, he has to up B! Oh. He didn't realize he...
Right. Pummel, very good mash out, but he just down smash for it. We
this
got an
is even,
game.
Yeah. Ooh, that was interesting.
I don't think he meant to do that Zare.
That was an interesting... Yeah, that was just an interesting exchange overall.
Oh, this could be bad.
Yeah. I would have gone
very
for
very risky. Oh, that...
Yep. I mean, that's what you're... I mean, if Mark doesn't grab ledge, right. you should just...
Wave land...
No,
oh,
no,
it.
No, no, no.
Bad
you hold,
DI on the throw.
You hold down every time.
I'll do it. Long Anchu takes a 2-0. Pretty solid.
Yeah.
Good performance from Steakhouse, though. He showed he was making the adaptations he needed.
Yeah, he definitely could have taken that game, but he wasn't willing. He wanted to be so aggro for some reason.
A lot of players want to be that way. Especially when you get to high level, because a lot of players like pride themselves in being able to play cool and aggro, but you can't get away with that the higher you go, because people are just going to punish you so hard for it.
Yeah.
And if you play more defensive, play more safe with your openings, try to just play more to the neutral instead of just fishing for punishes, then you're going to end up getting a lot better performance out of it.
Yep, I completely agree.
That was my own problem, because I used to try to play super aggressive and just run at people anonymously.
I still play aggressive.
I still do, but not as much.
Yeah. I play very aggressive unless it's very specific characters. Game & Watch is one of them. I have to play. I know that I need to play patience and that it's a spacing game. So
right.
That's kind of how I play around it.
All right, who's playing here?
Delta and
Delta.
Nia.
I don't know who Nia is. I do know who Delta is. Delta is a pretty old player from the Michigan area. He's been in the scene for a long time, at least a year longer than I have.
Oh, how long have you been playing?
Actually, I think my first tournament was early 2016.
Yeah, good on you to be first seed. I only got out second seed.
This guy's been out for a long time.
Nice.
He's a pretty decent Lucas. He was actually the one that kind of patented the original Dacus in neutral, which is why that's kind of a meme in Michigan right now. That's like what he's associated with.
Mm-hmm.
He's also a pretty good photographer. He's been taking shots throughout the event.
Nice.
But I don't know. He hasn't entered tournaments in a long time.
Oh, no. Are we going to get a Ditto?
Oh, for God's sake.
Oh.
I don't know if he knows this. He might have played it with Frost back when she lived in Michigan. But I don't know how much they played because Delta hasn't gone to much lately. He's gone to events, but only as a spectator. He's